Safety first, remember that.
It was right around 1 o'clock in the afternoon on a clear but cold spring day when Sergeant Brian Pearson and the officers of the Eastern District's drug squad.
Cover one, Ronnie is hands one, then I'm gonna have Steve come in. Cook, you're gonna ram. Go ahead,
executed a search warrant in the 1700 block of North Dallas Street.
Go, announce yourself, announce yourself. Come down, keep your hands right there, my man. Keep your hands right there. Watch him, cover him, Cook.
The North Dallas Street raid was just the beginning of a busy day for Pearson's eight-man team. The nine-year BPD veteran said his squad would execute another search warrant later in the day, thus maintaining the impressive pace they've been going at all year long.
Initially, we just found some residue where they've been shooting up, some blow stems where they've been snorting, a couple gel caps of heroin, some paraphernalia so far.
6-6-1-1-8-6-6.
Keep your hands up, my man.
In the past month alone, the Eastern Drug Squad has executed 17 search warrants, made 71 felony drug arrests, and seized 8 guns. It's numbers like those that have led to significant declines in crime throughout the Eastern District.
The community works real hard, and we're trying to work as hard for them as they do for us. You know, they don't deserve to live in fear.
In 2005, for example, the Eastern posted a 36% decline in homicides, an 18% decline in overall violent crime, and a 16% decline in total crime compared to 2004.
Everybody's working professionally and working as a team.
Major John Dotson, the Eastern's commander, says the progress made in his district is not just the result of good police work or new police technology. The Eastern now has 48 surveillance cameras, which are monitored at the district 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Just as important as all that, Dotson says, is the incredible work being done in concert with police by a growing number of community activists.
I think with the community involvement and with the change in the crime stats that we've seen over the years, I think it is changing. I think the perception that they're putting out on television, I don't think that no longer applies in the Eastern. I think the community's strong. I think it's a lot of involvement, and I think it's on a turnaround.
Crime is way down.
Elroy Christopher, Big Chris to those who know him and those who know of him, has long been one of the police department's biggest supporters and most important partners. He says from a quality of life perspective, there's no comparing the Eastern District of today with the district he moved into 19 years ago.
Quality of life, it's a lot better.
And that with the police and community working together, there's simply no limit as to how much safer still the district will become.
People was afraid to come out the house. They're not afraid anymore, right? The kids didn't come out in the street to play. Man, the kids come out there. Actually, we use a vacant lot down there in the neighborhood, right? That we use for a summer camp, right? We use it for after school, right? We use it for community picnics and everything, right? At one time, you couldn't do that.
Things are getting better. We're making progress. You know, we still have a long way to go, but things are definitely going well.